Hi. This is our third year PLDC assignment, Understanding ActionScript. ActionScript 2.0 is the language used to program with Flash games. It is very similar to JavaScript, but you don't need to know JavaScript to learn ActionScript. It provides more facilities than the Java to do our programming easily. Flash includes more than one version of ActionScript to meet the needs of different kinds of developers and playback hardware. ActionScript 3.0 executes extremely fast. This version requires somewhat more familiarity with object-oriented programming concepts than the other ActionScript versions. ActionScript 2.0 is simpler to learn than ActionScript 3.0. Although Flash Player runs compiled ActionScript 2.0 code slower than compiled ActionScript 3.0 code, ActionScript 2.0 is still useful for many kinds of projects that are not computationally intensive, for example, more design-oriented content. ActionScript 2.0 is also based on ECMAScript spec, but is not fully compliant. ActionScript 1.0 is the simplest form of ActionScript, and is still used by some versions of the Flashlight player. In here, you can see a screenshot of working interface of the Macromedia Flash MX. For this project, we used Macromedia Flash 8.0. Programming with ActionScript variables. In ActionScript, variables are used to hold the data. For example, you could create variable called score that could represent the number of points a player has in a game. Storing the player's points in the score variable enables you to work with the player's points without having to know the exact number of points the player has. Variables do not always contain numbers. They can contain true or false values, text, or any other type of data you can work with in Flash. In here, you will take a look at how to create variables in Flash and how it works. Declaring data type. To declare a data type for a variable, type a colon after the variable name and then the data type of the variable. The data type for a number is called number. The data type for text is called string, and the data type for true or false is called boolean, if you wanted. An excellent way to check for errors in your code is to tell Flash what type of data a variable will hold. This is called declaring a data type. That way, if you put a number in a variable that is supposed to hold text, Flash will tell you that you made a mistake in your code. This will help a lot when you start writing large blocks of code. Here are some sample data types. This is how to define a variable and use trace built-in function. Creating and editing symbols. Open Flash and create a new Flash file. Use the drawing tools in toolbar to draw a man on the stage. Using the selection tool, draw a selection area around the man to select it. Press F8 on your keyboard to convert the man to a symbol. Name the man enemy. Choose movie clip for the type, using test movie and the control to check the movie clip. This screenshot shows how it appears. ActionScript functions. Functions are a powerful feature in ActionScript that make it possible to reuse blocks of code throughout a Flash movie in great flexibility. Using functions saves the programmer a massive amount of time. They can be used to centralize the code so that everything can be controlled, edited and updated from a single point, and they also make the code much more easier to read by other people. There are two types of functions in ActionScript: built-in functions and custom functions. Here is an example for a simple mathematical function. Conditional statements. Conditional statement is an if or then statement. In other words, you have power to run a block of code only if a certain condition is true. You also have power to run a block of code only if a condition is not true. You can even set up multiple conditions that get checked in a particular order and the block of code run for the first condition that is true. Here is an example of a sample conditional statement. This screenshot shows how it appears. Loops in ActionScript. A loop is a block of code that runs a certain number of times. Loops help you to perform tasks where you repeat yourself. Using loops, it is just as easy to run a block of code one time as it is to run a block of code 1,000 times. Here is an example. Our target was not only doing a research on ActionScript, but also we hope to develop a little Flash game. In this moment we have achieved that goal successfully. This is the demonstration of our Flash game.